pasti ada begini nih, general English, business English, academic English, ya. Ini ada tiga ini. Apa sih sebetulnya bedanya? What are actually the differences about this, ya? Yeah? General English, of course this is general. If you want to everybody on the street speak with that general English. But business English is used in business, and academic English is used for academic. If you I hope you will you have you want to develop yourself and got scholarship overseas. Sekarang saya dengar kemarin dari teman dosen saya bahwa pemerintah itu sedang mengucurkan banyak sekali biaya untuk orang untuk scholarship. Jadi cari, you just only look for it di mana? Di Google, daripada ngeliatin TikTok aja terus-terusan, ya lebih baik cari kesempatan. That because the world is already open. Kalau di Indonesia ada namanya LPDP, ya LPDP, L London Papa Delta Papa. That's from Department of Finance, ya ininya scholarship. Kalau LPDP nggak bisa, then you browsing the university. Barangkali di Norway ada semuanya. Oh saya nggak bisa bahasa. No, now they have international class that they use English. Ya? So jadi general English untuk di sehari-hari, business English untuk business, academic English is for you to be able to learn or to study overseas. Ya. Yeah? In English, of course, academic English relate to TOEFL and IELTS. Remember about that. Apa sih bedanya? Lihat nih, general English. If you look at the words, semuanya kita tahu. Water, away, good, again, want, cat, animals, night, yeah, tree. Semuanya tahu. Ini gampang. Ini saya tahu ini ya. What about academic? This is academic, yeah. Language for writing in academic way in journals, yeah. Like in journals, kayak sekarang lagi S2 saya using academic English. I use academic English. But see, this is business English, yeah. Business English, of course, you sell about brand, budget, yeah, cost, customer. Trademark, deficit. These words mostly are not used in academic or in general. We will not talk about this in general. Kalau lagi ketemu ngobrol-ngobrol sama orang casually, yeah. So this is the three different genre, yeah, genre of English. Okay. And then what about business English? Business English, yeah. Now. Business at the office is actually the first one I want to talk about speaking. Speaking English. What is speaking English used in business world? Of course, it's telephoning. Telephoning itu sekarang udah nggak banyak dipakai, tapi maybe if you want to become a telemarketer or customer service, yeah, this is telephoning. And for meetings, meeting is for negotiation, yeah. For meetings, ini apa namanya? If you meet with international people, orang dari mungkin dari Arab, mungkin dari India, mungkin dari Korea, of course you use English, yeah. Okay, this is a little bit that maybe you know it, but you don't used to say it, yeah. So. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, yeah. This is we call it greetings, yeah. Greetings, remember, greetings in speaking, yeah. And then if you are in service area or if you meet people, if you work in finance company, but you meet people and somebody is quite confused, kalau ada orang yang lagi bingung-bingung, maybe that term, can I help you? Can I help you, sir? Can I help you? Coba kalau coba dilakukan. Oh, boleh. Can I help you? Ya. Yeah. Jadi enggak ngomong gini, can I help you? That's in English course or mungkin yang tahunya gitu. Can I help you? Itu semuanya orang Indonesia. Nah, 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 no. Can I help you? Can I help you? Nah, that things should be practiced. Yang seperti itu ekspresinya mesti dilatih. Kalau saya udah biasa ya. Can I help you? Can I help you, ma'am? Ya, karena saya juga kerja di hotel for a long time. Actually it's very very easy for me. And kalau ngomong yes 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 no, you don't say yes yes. Certainly, certainly. Ya, yeah? Kalau bilang you agree with something, oh certainly. Bolehkah saya nih? Oh certainly. Ya ya ya, ya. Enggak bisa kalau kita ngomong ya 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 ya. No, ya. Yeah? It is not business expressions in English. So, as simple as this. They have a special expressions. Sebetulnya itu kalau kita speaking in English itu mengenai ekspresi, expressions, ya. Yeah? Certainly, sir. Kenapa sih, ma'am, ngomongnya certainly? Yeah, that's how they say it, ya. Yeah? Oke. Okay. Seperti juga sekarang kebalikannya. Orang Indonesia sering maaf, Bu, ya. Yeah? Maaf it say sorry, but we use that as an not for apologize, untuk bukan untuk bilang maaf untuk sorry, tapi untuk ramah tamah atau untuk supaya sopan santun. Itu kan Indonesia. Jadi orang bule itu selalu bilang every time I have a new boss, they will ask, I don't understand Indonesia, why they always say sorry, ya? Yeah? When they don't need it. Oh, jadi dia juga itu bukan sorry, nggak usah pakai sorry, ya. So itu kan caranya kita berbicara. Semua bahasa sama, ya. This is how you speak in English. So, okay, maybe you can practice. Can I help you? Can I help you? Can I help you? Ya. Kalau good morning pasti bilang good morning, gitu kan ya. No, that's in classroom. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good afternoon, gitu ya. Jadi certainly, certainly, okay. And I just want to give you a little bit about give you an examples for example in telephony. Yeah? Answering calls have greetings namanya. Nah nanti kalau kita juga greetings itu di bahasa Inggris itu penting sekali. Enggak di speaking, enggak di nulis, karena dear sir, dear Mr. apa itu namanya juga greetings, ya. Nah, answering calls, that is greetings. Nah, saya punya pengalaman nih, waktu pertama kali, kan dulu zaman dulu masih pakai telepon ya. Kalau saya angkat telepon, halo, ya, halo. Of course my boss surprised and then he go on. I'm sorry Becky, you cannot answer the phone like that. Terus saya bingung, lah saya mesti jawabnya apa ya? Gak ada yang ngajarin kan waktu itu kan, ya. Yeah. But now there are a lot of YouTube, ya. Yeah. And so, for example, you can say good morning Jody speaking, good morning Jody speaking, or maybe you can say your name like good morning Sekar speaking, good morning Amalia speaking, ya. Yeah. And this is the standard that you have to say. Maybe you, and then or you can say ruang guru this is Sekar, ruang guru this is Sekar, yeah? Marketing office, ya, yeah? Jordi speaking, ya, yeah? Pakai speaking itu ya. How may how may I help you, how may I help you, tapi kita itu kan jadi how may I help you, how may I help you, ya, yeah? that's how you say it. Okay, let's practice it. You can say it. Yeah? Yes. Okay, let's practice. Okay, you can say, good morning, your first name speaking. How can I help you? How can I help you? Good morning, Becky speaking. How can I help you? Good morning, Pandu speaking. How can I help you? Yeah? Coba bisa nggak? Good morning. Good morning, Isma speaking. How can I help you? Yeah? Nah, itu harus dilatih. Harus dikatakan. If you want to be fluent in English, you have to say it. Because this, you have muscle memory. your mom, myself. Kalau saya kan udah good morning, make speaking, how may I help you? Ya, itu udah itu karena my muscle have already have memorizing it. So, but yeah, semuanya good morning, your first name or good morning, siapa speaking, how can I help you? Ya, yeah, oke. Okay. Papa, 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 papa. Ya, oke. Okay. Oke. Okay, nah, and also receiving calls. When you receive calls, who's this? Who's this? No. People can be offended. Jadi kayak kurang sopan kalau. Who's this? Ya, walaupun ngomongnya who's this gitu, udah, ya. Or you can be seen as an unprofessional. So, we should say who's calling please? Who's calling please? Who's calling please? Who's calling please? Ya, ini sedikit-sedikit aja nih ya kita. Pemakaiannya seperti ini. Yes, this is Erica speaking. How may I help you? Okay. Gimana mau minta wait ya. Yeah. Wait gitu. Mau minta supaya ini. Can you hold for a moment? Ya, yeah. Can you hold for a moment? Atau a moment please. Nah, kalau mau itu misalnya ke departemen lain, I'll put you through. Ini sebagian kecil dari speaking yang kita pakai sehari-hari, ya. Yeah. Oke, okay. Making a call. Nah, kalau bilang, "Hello, I want to speak to Pandu, Pak Pandu." "Hello, I want to speak to Pak Pandu." No, you don't say that. You have to, "Could I speak to Pak Pandu, please? Could I speak to Pak Pandu, please?" Ya. Yeah. And then kalau mau transfer, "Could you transfer me to marketing department?" Ya, yeah. "Could you transfer me to marketing department?" This you still need these expressions karena kalau you have a deal with overseas, ini kata-katanya kalau misalnya bisnis teman-teman itu di transnational, of course you have to use this. Jadi jangan bahasa Inggris general. Saya kalau sama murid saya bilang, hey, don't be street smart. Bahasa Inggris jalanan. Bahasa Inggris jalanan tidak bisa dipakai di business. So there is a specific way or specific phrases that are used in business world. Ini sebetulnya. Ya? Yeah? Okay. Now how about writing? Writing skills. Di writing skills juga begitu, ya. Yeah? Writing now is various. Nah, waktu saya kerja terakhir di AXA, karena itu BUMN ya, AXA Mandiri itu dari Mandiri dan AXA. Partner saya, apa teman saya itu dia biasa dengan CEO atau presiden direktur orang Indonesia, karena ini ganti orang Prancis, saya di hire di apa saya mau lagi kerja di situ. Nah, bos saya bilang ya, kan ke sekarang ini banyak pakai WhatsApp ya. Terus dia bilang misalnya namanya Amel, Becky, can you teach Amel how to use English? Terus saya bingung, kenapa ya? Kenapa? I think okay, how to write in English in a good manner, katanya gitu. Saya pikir okay, saya lihat bahasa Inggris kalau lumayan lah, kalau nulis email bisa gitu ya. Kenapa ya? Actually it's about her WhatsApp to the boss. Jadi dia itu caranya translate bahasa Indonesia ke WhatsApp, kan kita biasanya casual ya, Pak, Pak, misalnya gitu, Pak Saiful in front ya, you can come down, misalnya kayak gitu, kan dia bingung nih. You can say, Pak, the driver is waiting for you downstairs, you please, ya, mesti ada please-nya. You please come down to the lobby. Main kan, ya? Walaupun itu di WhatsApp, itu matters. Jadi, nah itu adalah business English writing skill. So there are two types of written communications now. You know, paper based yang ada kertasnya ya, itu pakai surat. Di sini Indonesia masih lumayan lah, masih tahu surat menyurat namanya. Ya. Reports, of course, annual report, financial report, contracts masih paper based. Tapi sekarang banyak kan paperless atau paperless atau digital, WhatsApp ya, yeah, or text, and then emails and presentation materials. That's the written in communication or written English, business English that you have to pay attention and you have to learn specific phrases atau kata-kata atau kalimat yang dipakai di sini, karena itu spesifik semuanya. Ini saya punya waktu saya kerja ya. Thanks for that. Lihat nih, ini bos saya bilang thanks for agenda for marketing I want ya. Dia good morning ya. Pokoknya mereka seperti enggak jangan kayak casual ya. Terus tulis itu jangan huruf kecil semua. It is offended ya. Bahasa Inggris itu sangat penting, capitalization atau huruf besar kecil itu sangat penting. I ya, like I ya, itu mesti I besar selalu. Okay, ya. If you see this ya, this is exaggerated. Ini adalah contoh dari orang yang nggak tahu menempatkan diri ya. The English is very good ya, bahasa Inggrisnya bagus, kemudian nggak ada grammar yang salah, but that's not it ya. Kalau mau ngelamar kerjaan nggak seperti ini ya. No rest, I'm just chilling. Nggak boleh gitu ya. We call it tone of the email. Tone itu ada formal, informal ya, ada tone-nya. Then this is the thing that you have to learn. Of course, grammar, vocabulary and expressions ya, itu spelling penting, sentence structure ya, how you structure your sentence and sentence length. Okay, ya. So, now how sekarang nih kalau misalnya Anda mau belajar sendiri, there are a lot of examples in Google. Yeah, just ask Mr. Google. For example, this is basic request. Yeah, you want to email the basic request, follow up message. Yeah, thank you for taking the time. Ini bahasanya memang begitu. Please let me know if you need any more. Itu memang begitu selalu. Thank you again, and I hope to hear from you. Itu begitu memang. Yeah. Okay. This is an example about. This is communication in written, yeah, email, and apa namanya. Now about how about report? Ini report juga, ya, yeah? Because report itu di bahasa Inggris itu adalah begini. Orang Indonesia kita nih, saya nih, biasanya cuma nulis saja. No, in English you have to prepare, ya, yeah? Preparing you would lihat outline-nya apa, and then writing the first draft. And editing it, and then produce the final. Paling enggak ada editing, okay? And also the structure-nya ini, structure dari report itu selalu sama kalau di bahasa Inggris. Maybe now is also the same in bahasa Indonesia, but sometimes Indonesia is kan enggak konsisten ya. But on English, you have to have this. You have to have title. You have to have table of content, you have to have executive summary, yeah, introduction, main body, conclusion. That's all about this ya. Yeah. So ini adalah tempat-tempat phrases that you have to know for learning English. I think Pandu, I think maybe we can do our question and answer now because there are a lot of, it's already 99.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Miss Becky, for your presentation. But I think your presentation is so adorable for me because it's all about the business thing, and we are start to teman-teman kan baru masuk, pengen masuk ke teman kerja gitu ya, dan ini dibutuhkan oleh teman-teman gitu. Jadi kayak dan ini pas banget buat teman-teman yang pengen banget pas dunia kerja. So, I'm inviting you guys to start asking a question. If you have question, please just write down to Q&A box or just raise your hand and I will help you to open your microphone and you can just ask anything to Miss Becky. Anyone?
The drama is raising hand.
Okay. I think Nugroho Ningsih ya.
Nugroho Ningsih ya.
Yes.
What is your question?
Nugroho Ningsih, please unmute your microphone.
Gak apa-apa, bahasa Indonesia juga gak apa-apa. Kita lebih baik mengerti kan?
Betul.
Gak usah.
Ada? Oke, Nugroho Ningsih belum respon, kita move dulu ya, kita ke Urai ya, Mira. Ya. Oke, silakan dengan pertanyaannya.
I'm not ready to question.
It's okay. Just talk in bahasa Indonesia. It's okay.
Saya belum siap untuk bertanya.
Oh, belum siap. Oke, deh.
Oke, sip. Yes. Thank you, Nugroho Ningsih. I saw Nugroho Ningsih on his hand, so I'll lower your hand. So I'll let Amira, Ure Amira Neselia to open your microphone.
Okay. Miss Becky, excuse me.
Yes. Dad, excuse me, nggak boleh ya. Excuse me, okay. Itu bahasa Indonesia. No, you don't say that. Don't translate.
Yeah. My name is Urai Amira. I'm from BKK BLK 5.2.
Oh.
First thing first, I want to ask you about some tips or advice for me because I'm a passive English kind of person, so I think my ability to understand what people say or in listening and reading is better than if I try to speak in English. So it is hard for me to use my vocabulary and maybe I have trouble to talk in public, so maybe is there any advice or tips for me, Miss Becky, to at least improve my English to be more active? Thank you.
Okay, is it Urai? Can I call you Urai? Or Amira? Yeah. Urai. Yeah. Okay, Urai. Your English is very good. Your English is very good. You speak in quite fluent English. It's okay. Kenapa rasanya itu kok enggak bisa ya? It's only your anxiety. Karena semuanya cuma takut. Melihat bahasa Inggris itu sangat tinggi, melihat bahasa Inggris itu sangat enggak, biasanya begitu. Di saya tuh kalau kan saya kan selalu di tempat bos ya. Nah, saya selalu panggil kalau ada yang baru, aduh ini kayak Urai ini bagus nih, si bos mesti tahu nih. Saya suka masukin, "Urai sini, masuk. Ngomong sama bos." Enggak bisa ngomong. Actually, you have no problem in your English. Remember, English is only a tool.
Yes.
A tool. Enggak ada yang tinggi, enggak ada yang enggak. Saya itu punya handphone. Handphone is a tool. Saya mesti bisa makainya. Nah, let me explain to you about learning English. Kebetulan saya kan di linguistik ya, itu namanya psycholinguistik. Language is skill, bukannya matematik loh, bukannya belajar x plus 2 kuadrat, bukan, ya, nggak perlu di ini. Karena seperti belajar sepeda, siapa yang pernah belajar sepeda? Semua belajar sepeda kan? Tapi kalau belajar sepeda, tahunya, oh iya ini pedalnya, I know, ini pedal mesti digayu, mesti dijalanin, but if you don't use it, you cannot do it. Seperti saya, dulu saya waktu kecil main sepeda bisa diangkat-angkat stangnya, ya, Wah, udah bisa begitu. Sekarang kalau naik sepeda karena nggak pernah lagi, lalu iu, ya, itu lagi. It is about English. For example, like now, yeah, I don't. Fortunately, I have English speaking church, so I still speak in English. But I don't. I'm not working in company, right? And I don't have any bosses. I don't have any people who speak in English in business term. I only teach. You know what? It's some kind of changing my English. Jadi semuanya itu harus dipakai, ya. Gimana sih pakai nanti kita akan saya kasih lihat gimana. Tapi yang penting adalah seberapa jauh Anda mau improve. Kadang-kadang kan gimana ya? Cuman ngomongnya gimana aja, tapi pengennya tuh tiba-tiba bangun dari tidur, tau tiba-tiba bisa was-was, yang nggak bisa, yes. Atuh, ya. Jadi kalau mau nyetir, atau kalau kita, saya, I'm a musician, so kalau kita mau belajar gitar, belajar piano, itu masuk harus praktis, harus tahu lagu apa yang kita mau belajar, itu phrases. Nah, saya mau itu ya, bahasa itu saya di kantor tuh banyak sekali trainee dari luar negeri, like management trainee from overseas, okay? So how they put it, ini kan karena bahasa Inggris itu phrases ya, how you say it in English, namanya gitu, how you say it in English. Nah, mereka itu bertanya kepada saya sama Becky, how can I say you if I want to ask you to have lunch with me, ya? Terus kalau saya karena suka bercanda, dia bilang yuk lunch bareng, ya. Padahal what is bareng, ya? Tapi that's because that is the daily, ya. Saya nggak bisa mari kita makan bersama, kan nggak pernah kalau di kita ngomong begitu di sehari-hari. Of course I have to say if it is an what casual friendship, I would say yuk Becky makan bareng yuk, gitu. Jadi dia makan bareng. Sampai itu dia bilang, Becky barang makan, yuk barang makan. No, it's not barang. Barang is different, ya. Yeah? So, but the one that they ask is how can I say it? The expression. Kalau orang travel buku-buku travel pasti gitu deh. How can I ask the shop attendees? How can I gitu ya? Karena itu yang dipakai. So, how do you improve your English? You have to say it. You have to listen. Nanti kita lihat ya. You have to say and you have to listen.
Okay, thank you very much, Miss Becky.
Okay.
Thank you, Rai.
I think can we continue or continue dulu aja ya?
Ada satu pertanyaan lagi, mungkin ini juga bisa dijawab singkat juga oleh Miss Becky. Okay, so ada pertanyaan di kolom Q&A, coba aku bacakan di sini. Hello Miss, good evening. I want to ask question. If someone say excuse me, kita mesti jawab apa? Because saya pernah di sebuah lift hotel and I say yes, terus diketawain. Dan kalau ada yang bilang what's up, jawab aja apa ya Miss ya? Thank you.
Oh yes, how can I help you? How can I help you? Or can I help you? Yes, can I help you? Kan udah yes kan?
Yes.
Apa? Yes, can I help you? Jadi you offer your help kan?
Okay.
Karena kalau dia bilang excuse me, dia kan pasti mau bertanya atau mau itu. Jawabannya.
Kadang di Indonesia excuse me-nya lewat gitu. Permisi mau lewat. Jadi excuse me.
Bukan. Itu Indonesia
apa ya? Beda ya konsepnya ya. Mungkin nanti dari Anissa juga kalau konteksnya adalah excuse me, biasanya orangnya mau minta tolong, mau tanya sesuatu hal. Jadi kalau misalnya jawabnya adalah what can I do for you? Or can I help you?
Gitu. Can I help you?
Yes. Okay. Kita lanjutkan dulu sedikit. Ada
ini ada Amirah nih. Amirah. Sometimes I feel my English is superior when I speak in my brain. You speak to yourself then. But when it's come to my mouth, when I have to speak it up, it's terrible. What do you mean by terrible? So you mean by your pronunciation? If you listen to, you understand your English, yeah? And like a toddler learning speaking her mouth, of course, you become a toddler first. Kalau nggak pernah keluar, jadi toddler. Ba-ba-ba, minum tutu. Nggak bisa bilang susu. Minum tutu. Tapi ada di mana, gitu kan? It's a toddler. It's a process. Tapi prosesnya itu harus dijalankan. Karena kalau kita mother tongue, kita akan berpikir terus sampai ini kita itu secara natural kita itu akan change my perception, change our perception or and our pronunciation, ya, secara alamiah. Itu ada di makanya ada yang namanya Noam Chomsky, dia bilang kita tuh di otak kita ada grammar di sini. Jadi grammatical, kita udah bisa ada sistem di sini, sistem kita. Now, because language English is maybe your second or third language, jadi you have to practice it. Saya mungkin, Amira mungkin dari mana nih? Kalau mungkin dari luar Jakarta, pasti nggak ngomong seperti orang Jakarta yang kalau ngomong cepet banget katanya, right? So saya waktu itu ada anak dari daerah ke tempat saya tinggal sama saya sekarang, dulu dia nggak ngerti saya ngomong apa. They know, he knows bahasa Indonesia of course, but he doesn't understand my bahasa Indonesia, ya? Yeah? So it's practice. Jadi kalau misalnya pronunciation, you practice it. You don't have to be like an English people that you have. Saya suka ketawa, that, of course, that, yes, gitu ya. Saya pernah waktu itu di kelas RIK ya, di kelas nurse, di kelas keperawatan di UI. Dia bilang, Miss, how come your English is not like British? And I don't want to be British. My English is like this. This is my English. It's okay. Now it's global English. Jadi jangan takut karena kok saya nggak seperti orang British ya. Nggak usah. Pak Jokowi ingat? Pak Jokowi itu ngomongnya Japanese English loh. But he becomes the head of G7, right? It's okay. Be yourself. Nah ya katanya tuh. Amira is from ada yang Makassar Sulawesi. So you have your own language. Jadi itu seperti Anda belajar bahasa Indonesia, ya. Yeah? So it's okay if we speak Medok English. Of course, it's okay. As long as they understand it. For example, if you say ini ya, kalau di ini suka kalau bahasa orang Medok itu selalu nde, pakai nde ya. Pak, the boy is not in the bathroom, yeah. Of course, they confuse. What do you mean by that? So you have to lesser it. So kayak kita kalau bilang saya mau cahu di mana tahu cahu cempi gitu kan? Maksudnya tempe. Ya kan?
Yeah.
I will say to the tempe, it is the same. Every language has the same. Saya mau belajar bahasa Makassar juga gitu dong, ya kan? Saya mesti kalau mesti pisang gitu kan, mesti kalau bahasa Sunda mah mesti gimana kan gitu. Harus gitu. Language is the same. Every language has their own system. Then you have to know the system and you follow the system. Jangan resisten. Mau sistem saya nih, saya punya dua HP ya, satu smartphone, satu iOS, satu Apple, right. Satu Android, ya. Oma-oma tuh biasanya kan Android ya, terus mau jadi sok-sokan pakai Apple, nggak bisa begitu loh. Karena apa? I force ya the system si Android system to the iOS, ya sampai kapan juga nggak bisa.
Yes.
If you say you cannot do it, maybe you translate it in your head. Jangan pakai translate, ya? Yeah? Okay. Yeah?
Okay. So I think the underlined statement from your answer, Miss Becky, is a communication or bahasa or English is bagaimana orang itu bisa paham sama makna kita gitu ya, penyampaiannya, kata-katanya itu kebalik-balik itu gak apa-apa gitu teman-teman. Jadi kadang-kadang malah teman-teman bule itu tahu paham maksud kita meskipun
betul
naruhnya kebalik-balik, that's okay. Jadi mereka akan menghormati kita, jadi jangan malu untuk berbahasa Inggris.
except in writing.
Oh, okay, in writing.
Kalau tulis, karena kan punya waktu untuk lihat ya.
Yes.
Mana sistemnya, mana sih sistemnya crash ya? You know ya, dari sistem. Then in written you have you have to have terutama email ya. Email. Kalau WhatsApp masih kayak conversation, tapi email then you have to be careful.
Okay. Don, kita akan lanjutkan lagi Peggy untuk materi berikutnya. Pertanyaannya tahan dulu teman-teman. Kalau bisa mau tanya lagi langsung di Q&A ya. Silakan.
Okay. Peggy. Now I share. Now it is. Now this is the one that I think you need this. English for applying jobs. Karena sebentar lagi Anda akan applying jobs. Nah biasanya ya Anda akan di interview atau dites dalam bahasa Inggris. Okay. So, before that, I want, ini penting sekali Anda tahu hiring prosesnya, ya. Jangan nanti putus asa atau ya saya kok nggak dipanggil ya. Oh, kok interviewnya banyak banget ya. Karena itu yang harus diketahui apa dilakukan. It's a process, sebenarnya proses. Oke, okay, hiring proses ya. Gimana perusahaan itu ambil pegawai, ya? Bagaimana? Of course, the first is screening process, di screen. Yang masuk itu application 3 juta umat, oke? Ya? Di mana masuknya? Di HRD namanya, atau Human Resources Division, or Human Capital sekarang. Jadi kalau lihat Human Capital, atau talent, ya? Talent, ada talentnya itu human, ini, untuk cari pegawai. Oke? What, how? They screen the application. Screening the application. Nah, what actually you have to do? What is your role here? Gimana nih kompetitifnya? Coba you work on your resume or CV. CV-nya mesti menarik, mesti catching, ya kan? Kalau banyak, lama, kalau ini boring, biasanya dibuang. Oke? Okay? Jadi, make sure that you do your resume or CV in a very proper and good way in English. Oke? Okay? Abis gitu, ada mungkin employment test. Sudah nih dipilih ya. Dari mungkin application-nya 1000, jadi 300. And then there is employment test. One test is maybe English test. This English test is actually a sort of English placement test, or we call it aptitude test. Sampai mana sih bahasa Inggrisnya? Nah, perusahaan sekarang ini saya setiap hari itu cuma kerjaannya ngajarin TOEFL, karena mereka itu basicnya tuh TOEFL. Tapi TOEFL-nya itu nggak tinggi-tinggi ya, itu seperti 450 itu udah oke, okay, ya. So sebetulnya TOEFL itu nggak itu penting, atau namanya mesti TOEIC, TOEIC, TOEIC yang mesti ya. Seperti itu. Jadi kalau misalnya ada employment test bahasa Inggris, Google aja, lihat kayak apa. Nanti ada jawabannya, ada semuanya, ya. Atau tanya saya, ya. Nanti saya kan bilang I'm your friend forever. So you can call apa, you can WhatsApp me, ya. I can lead you. And then, if you are dari employment test itu kan banyak yang nggak bisa segala macam. Ini tes IQ juga, ya. Sometimes kalau skill, tes the skill, and then interview process. Now kita ini sebetulnya mau ngomong tentang English for interview. How you can succeed in interview using your English, ya. Interview process. Yang pertama itu dari HRD kan, dia panggil satu-satu, ya. Talent scout namanya, talent scout satu-satu. And then kalau udah cocok nih dia yang cocokin. And then user, this is become the department yang anda pilih ya, yang anda itu. They screen ya, screen. And then kalau udah bagus jadi lebih kecil lagi, the department head in the department. Department head ya, udah bosnya. Udah, tapi di department kan biasanya gitu. Screening lagi, manager terus interview lagi. Kalau udah, mungkin udah tinggal 5, ke manajemen namanya. This is to board of director, di director. Sometimes to director, sometimes enggak. Tapi kalau misalnya Anda, biasanya kalau baru masuk enggak ya, sampai si department head aja. Tapi kalau yang udah mahir, udah role-nya itu cukup menjadi manager, biasanya masuk ke board of director atau management. So, interview lagi, ya, baru ke HRD. Yang terakhir itu job offer namanya, and negotiation on salary. Do you have to negotiate? Yes. Jangan bilang iya-iya aja, tapi hatinya enggak iya. Ya? You can ask. Karena ini hubungan kerja loh. Bukannya seperti we are not in slavery time. Remember ya, kita bukannya di perbudakan ini. Jadi kalau enggak cocok, ya jangan. Jadi mesti ini agak negosiasi. Dia offer, pasti ada job offer. Ini loh, seperti ini jobnya, jam kerja segini, harganya segini. So, this is the thing. If you now later on your first job, of course you say yes. Tapi yang kira-kira aja, kalau cuma dibayar 1,5 juta, ya jangan. Ya, yeah? So, sometimes company is very abusive. Ya, yeah? Okay. Yeah, this is the hiring process yang that you have to know. PR Anda di mana? PR-nya di resume. Ya, yeah? This how you make your CV. Now, what are you going to do to prepare yourself? Sekarang nanti nih, ya. Yeah? Prepare a written resume. Ya, yeah? A written resume. A lot of tips. Banyak, mau di YouTube ada, mau di baca ada, semuanya ada ya. Nah, kedua, if you apply in a company, jangan cuma apply karena mau dapat kerjaan aja. Ya, coba cari company yang you want to work in. Coba sekarang pikir, mau kerja apa sih dreamnya? This is the time that I want to say you have to dream big. Saya mau setelah pertama kali mungkin saya di Harvard itu, saya mau kerja di World Bank karena waktu itu Bank Dunia itu World Bank itu rasanya waduh prestis banget ya kalau masuk ke World Bank. Seorang lulusan IKIP aja mau ke World Bank. It's okay. Ya, yeah, it's okay. Kan coba enggak bayar. Enggak ada yang bayar semuanya, ya. Yeah? Itu aja maju aja, ya. Yeah? So, then you get the idea about the company. I get all ideas about company that I apply. Jadi, get the idea about the job first. Karena nanti kalau di interview tuh kan related to the job, ya. Yeah? Saya mau kerja sebagai apa? Sebagai audit, sebagai as an engineer, ya, yeah? As an apa? Di bagian apa? Itu purchasing, itu semuanya get the idea. Have a little research about the company. Karena itu penting. PT Kalbe Farma. Apa sih Kalbe Farma ya? Mungkin ada yang enggak tahu Kalbe Farma apa. Google aja Kalbe Farma. Oh, dia ini. Oh, bosnya siapa aja ya? Oh, ini. Oh, pernah lihat nih di TV. You have a little research about the company. Find a website, read through it, yeah. See what companies do actually, yeah. Now, kalau you have your specific skills, yeah, specific skills, for example, engineering biasanya ya, yeah? IT, kemudian finance, itu semuanya gitu ya. Misalnya mau payroll, bagian income, ya, yeah? Income. Nah. Get prepared in your technical terms. Misalnya mau ke apa namanya sebagai F&B ya, F&B waiters itu ada semuanya. Get the, sebetulnya technically apa aja sih waiters, jadi apa aja. You can only, it's only a YouTube away. Coba cari ya. So this is a little bit about tips how you prepare yourself. Now, and then, when you call for an interview, aduh deg-degan. Now, you should be confident. Karena ya, karena si perusahaan ini kan udah pilih dari banyak orang. Dia pilih Anda, itu gak sia-sia. Jadi, you are competent enough. Yeah? So, You are fit for the company. Itu adalah langkah pertama supaya Anda itu bisa berdiri tegak. Ya, don't ever ever let your anybody let you down. Itu saya tidak membiarkan diri saya direndahkan oleh orang lain. Tapi bukannya saya sombong, jangan sombong, nggak boleh sombong, tapi saya punya, saya tahu apa yang saya punya. And you have to have that too. You are now getting a scholarship from Ruang Guru. You are chosen people. Kalian ini dipilih dari begitu banyak orang. Berarti kan ada strength-nya. So, yeah, please put it in your mind. So, this is about the interview. Ini pertanyaannya sama ini aja. If you Google, ini keluar lagi, ya. Yeah? Okay, tell me about yourself. Itu pasti itu. Tell me about yourself, ya. Yeah? And then, biasanya kalau pertama kali, kedua saya ini interview saya nggak pernah diinterview. Kedua ini waktu udah lama kerja di Harvard mau keluar. And then saya ingat waktu itu this is a Fox movie company yang untuk apa Century 21 untuk filmmaker. Ini orang bilang tell me about yourself. What? Yeah, tell me about yourself. Okay. Tell me the good things about you that sell yourself. Sell yourself that I want to buy what you sell. Itu mengena di saya dan saya mulai untuk begitu. Di ini dulu di apa namanya mulai di apa di rumah di apa dihafalkan di expression seperti apa what actually you want to say about yourself and then why should we hire you? Itu pertanyaan. Apa sih untungnya saya ini jadiin Anda employee sini. Kalau tidak pernah tahu tentang company-nya, of course you don't know. Nah, itu maksudnya bisa bagaimana? Why should we hire you? Or why do you want to work here? See? Ya kan? As simple as I said, I am very, I know that this company is very very prominent and very prestigious company and I want to be in the work in this company. Waktu itu saya cuma ngomong kayak gitu. I think I will be very proud if somebody ask me where I work and I said I'm from Worldbank. Itu yang membuat saya bisa diterima. Ya? Yeah? Ya? Yeah? What other jobs you have? Nah, ini apakah Anda rajin apa enggak nih, ya? Yeah? Describe a time you had to deal with a different situation, and then tell me about the time you work with the team, yeah. And lihat, I get this from books. Semuanya ada. Tell me about yourself. Udah ada nih kiat-kiatnya. You can answer this question by telling the interview about career. Yeah. Ini adalah pertanyaan di IELTS, yeah. IELTS, tahu IELTS kan? IELTS, ya, itu ada tes IELTS speaking. Kalau bisa IELTS speaking ya, itu namun tapi IELTS general ya, ada general, ada academic. Yang general English, it's all about little bit about question like this, ya. Nah, sekarang ada itu I recently graduated from UIN, ya. And then you say with a bachelor degree terus dijabarkan aja apa yang good things about you that you want to promote to people so you can they want to buy kan sama aja selling ini kan selling diri kita kan supaya dibeli. Tell me about yourself. Why should we hire you? Ini ya dibilang entry job interview, ask this question because they want to know how hard you are willing to work, ya kan? And how hard that you can use in the position. Yeah? I would be an asset to your company. Kayaknya, ini banyak banget ya. No, I think I would be. Kan I would be, saya pingin sekali, I want to be an asset in your company as a specialist. Nah, kalau ada ininya kan ini ada sebagai apa ya? Then you know apa sih karakter-karakter apa yang Anda punya yang bisa dijabarkan. Saya selalu cuma bilang I'm very honest. Anda tahu honesty itu sangat jarang. I'm honest people. I will not steal money. Itu sangat jarang. Ya. I will not corrupt. Itu sangat jarang. I'm a person with full of integrity. Integritas itu sangat mahal. Kalau Anda punya integritas, itu yang dicari orang. Mungkin juga enggak, tapi kalau cuma punya itu, enggak punya apa-apa lagi, enggak punya skill apa-apa. I have an integrity in my, I know that I'm working hard. I'm a hard worker. Itu yang paling enak kan? I want to learn all the time. I'm fast learner. Ya, itu. So, why do you want to work here? Ya kan? I follow your company on social media throughout my time in art school. Kan? I love the style of you. Itu kan, itu dipikirkan apa ya sekarang? Kenapa saya mau kerja di situ? Nah, supaya dapat kerjaan aja. No. It's not. Why do you want to work in, for example, in Gojek? I want to be in that company, startup. Oh, bilang, I want to be a startup company because I want to do my own startup company. Bisa begitu juga kan? Yeah. So what are the jobs to help if you have any experiences, even as part-timer, as internship, your intern, atau mungkin sebagai apa di sekolah, right? Sebagai secretary in your apa manual apa-apa. Then you say it. I work as a what? Yeah. So they want to know what skills that you have. Now this is ini agak susah karena you have to explain. Kalau dihadapi dengan yang susah ya, situasi susah, describe a time you had to deal with difficult situation. How did you handle it? Biasanya ini ya, kalau udah kesini itu pertanyaannya kayaknya udah Anda udah mungkin 70% 80% Anda udah mulai mau diterima tuh. Karena harus tahu bagaimana Anda solving problems, because in workplace all the time you are problem solver. Okay, yeah. Okay. Okay, now that's how to English for getting your employment. Karena ini bisa semuanya dicari di internet. Ya. Yeah? Pakai keyword aja, keywordnya interview prompt. Gitu-gitu. Okay? So okay, now a little bit about how to improve. Tapi improving your English now. Ini selalu jadi pertanyaan. Ini selalu jadi why I can speak English well. Ya, yeah? Ini selalu jadi I cannot speak well. I cannot speak. This is an example. Ya, lihat ya. Kalau lagi if you fall in love to someone, ya. Yeah? Jadi gagap kan? Jadi gagap because there is anxiety. So, itu sama aja ya. You maybe it's your anxiety, ya. Di otak Anda adalah saya tidak mampu. Tapi kenapa saya tidak mampu? Karena bahasa Inggris tuh tinggi banget, bagus banget. No, English is a tool of communication. So, you can start use the language. And how? The first thing is you have to like the language. I have an example of when kan kalau di UI itu kita ngajarnya itu tiap semester itu diganti-ganti ya. So for example, satu saya di Fakultas Sastra apa FIB namanya FIB MIPA, jadi selalu diganti-ganti. Now when I if I taught in FIB namanya Fakultas Ilmu Budaya, there are a lot of there were students from Korean and then Russia, bahasa language Russian language. Bahasa Inggrisnya nggak bisa sama sekali. Tapi mereka bilang, oh bahasa Rusia itu lebih gampang daripada bahasa Inggris. In fact, how long you have been exposed to English, how long you learn English. Itu kenapa? Karena di otak ini udah menolak. You have to like the language. Seperti kalau siapa yang suka BTS, suka Korea pop, K-pop, ya pasti kalimat-kalimat Anyang Seo atau Sarangai udah tahu itu. Les bahasa Korea nggak? Enggak. Because you like it. It is that you embrace it. You embrace the language. Buka hati ini, buka pikirannya. Then if you like the language, of course you have a power in yourself, in within your heart, itu untuk pengen tahu dan untuk belajar, ya, untuk tak pengen tahu. Then you have to expose yourself in English. How? Read or sing, ya, listen, and then read, ya. So this is the one that I want to share to you. Ya, gimana sih bahasa itu di apa namanya dipelajari? If you want to speak well, you have to listen a lot. Have a listening. Ini ada listening, speaking, reading, writing. Ya, listening and speaking. This is the two that correlate one to each other. Jadi seperti anak-anak bayi itu dia dengar dulu baru ngomong. It's also in second or third language. Listening, then you can speak it out. Karena apa itu mesti masuk ke your long term memory, the words, the vocabularies, the system, ya. Lama-lama itu jadi namanya there is automatization. Nah, gimana caranya dari listening, ya? Listening itu nggak gampang juga, ya. There are a lot of apa ya? Yang sebetulnya itu pronunciation-nya different, ya. I want to tell you something. Satu kali I work in Grand Hyatt Jakarta. My boss is Swiss German, but of course we talk in English. Yeah, okay. One time, there is a new food and beverage director, which is a British person. Dia British dari bahasa dia English. And then whenever the boss, he said that I don't understand what the boss said. They talk in English. Yeah, and then apa namanya every time he has a meeting. Because it's I'm outside the boss office, he said, Becky, can you listen to what your boss said and tell me? I want to ask you what is actually he's talking about. Yeah, jadi emang bahasa Inggris saya lebih bagus daripada dia yang udah lahirnya pakai bahasa Inggris. Kenapa dia nggak bisa ngomong bahasa Inggris dengan bosnya, dengan bos saya? Emang saya lebih jago? No, it is. Because I'm used to it. I work for him for 11 years. I know the tone. I know the pronunciation. Nah, seperti itu pronunciation berbeda-beda. Kalau orang saya sekarang lagi apa namanya lagi my dissertation is about Indonesian who are graduated from Jakarta International School, British School, gitu kan nggak bisa, katanya nggak bisa ngomong bahasa Indonesia lagi, ya. Yeah? They lost their Indonesians. You know, there are a lot of kids like that. And then going overseas untuk sekolah. Nah, mereka itu pas sampai ke Amerika, mereka nggak bisa ngomong bahasa Indonesia loh. Ngomongnya bahasa Inggris di Indonesia. Nggak ngerti waktu when the native speaker or they just only go to United States. They bilang, I don't understand what they are talking about. Jadi dia nggak ngerti, ya. Yeah? So there are a lot of things yang harus di ini listening. Tapi yang paling Anda bisa lakukan adalah listen a lot. Listening. Kalau misalnya Anda mau di pekerjaan, saya selalu bilang kalau saya ngajar bisnis Inggris, saya mau Anda dengerin CNN. Saya mau Anda dengerin. Yeah, one time I taught CEO of from Uniqlo. Gak bisa ngomong bahasa Inggris, gak bisa ngomong bahasa Indonesia. Jadi kita dia ngerti kalau listening, tapi speakingnya nggak bisa. And then I said, okay, ini kan business ya, so you watch CNN, watch CNN. Oh, I don't, no understand. Senche, dia panggil saya Senche. And then around 3 months, 2 months later, and then, hey Senche, now I understand. So, karena orang Jepang itu sangat nurut sama gurunya ya. Jadi rupanya dia lakukan. So, listening is you, your memory, your head, your brain get used to the sound of English. And then this is you intake namanya. Intake. Then you kalau mau lebih fluent, you have to mimicking. Mulai dibicarakan. Kalau dia nurutin aja dia ngomong apa. This is how you practice your listening and speaking. Now reading and writing. Apakah orang yang speakingnya jago bisa writing? No. Itu tidak nyambung. If you want to do in writing, you have to read a lot. Bahas orang Jepang itu writingnya bagus, readingnya bagus, tapi dia nggak bisa speaking. Yeah. So this is the four language that that you have to know. Ini prosesnya seperti ini. So in language, yeah, there are two criteria. Fluency yang pertama, ngomong aja fluency. And then after that, accuracy. Ngomongnya udah akurat, udah bagus. Kalau biasanya orang yang kalau fluency mau ngomong aja hajar bleh, akurasinya kurang. Nah, akurasi itu harus dilatih dan you have to monitor your English actually. You have to monitor what you said. Ya, itu ada akurasi. Fluency, ada orang yang nah, the person who say that I can speak in English in my brain. Yeah, you are, maybe your accuracy is good, but you cannot be fluent. Takut salah. Nah, ini orang Jepang selalu begitu. Malu kalau salah. Nggak apa-apa, salah lagi. Yeah, just speak it up. Yeah, just say it. Sorry. So how to, nah ini, kalau kursus itu apa sih sebetulnya? Actually the courses, ya, English courses is actually for giving you a simulation of a place for you to practice your skill, practice your listening or practice your speaking, yeah, or practice your writing and practice your reading. This is the place that you the only the place, yeah. And then of course they give you the way. It is to increase your accuracy. Jadi akurat grammarnya. Kita jangan kalau ngomong grammar langsung pusing ya. The system of the language, yeah. It's the same, sama structure grammar itu. Or how you say it, bilangnya pronunciation. Correct vocabulary choice, ya, kadang-kadang kata-katanya nggak cocok, ya, kayak excuse me tadi, ya, or I'm sorry, ya kan, excuse me, I'm sorry itu nggak cocok di bahasa Indonesia. Jadi, because you translate it, if you keep translating your Indonesian to English, then there are possibilities you have problems all the time. Jadi nggak boleh ditranslate. Now, how you can develop your accuracy? Of course, you can join English course like Ruang Guru, yeah, LBI, LIA, yeah, because I am from LBI and I said LBI, or you can do your self-study. This is the very good website from BBC, yeah, BBC Learning English. There are a lot of materials that you can use, yeah, and then watch YouTube, yeah. This is the English Academy Ruang Guru. You can just join this class. This is LBI, yeah. I don't know how much is Ruang Guru charge you, but LBI for one semester, 3 months is only 1.5 1,250,000, 1,350,000, 1,750,000, 1,750,000. Gak terlalu mahal untuk 3 bulan. And of course you can do it by yourself. Seperti ini, ya. Yeah. If you want to see the IELTS speaking, ya, yeah, how to introduce yourself. Ada nih di sini, ya. Yeah. 30 minutes English listening practice for beginners or for apps up till advanced, ya. Yeah. Ini semuanya ada di sini. Conversation, even writing, grammar, semuanya ada. Why grammar? Grammar because you want to put the words in correct way. You put all the vocabularies in the system. Itu namanya grammar. In English grammar, ya kalau Indonesia, time and verb itu nggak change. Saya mau saya bermain bola. Saya suka bermain bola. I like apa? Saya bermain bola sekarang. Ya, yeah, I'm playing football now. Saya bermain bola kemarin, kalau bahasa Inggris saya bermain bola kan cuma kemarin, apa kata waktunya berbeda. Bahasa Inggris I played football. This is the one that we call tenses, ya, pusing ya. And of course there is noun sama verbs, relationship, ada yang tambah s, ada yang nggak tambah s, ya. That's the system that you have to know. Sama aja kalau ini gimana ya, pakai ini gimana, pakai Android. Nah, it's a system only. Jadi jangan melihatnya sebagai sesuatu yang udah kalau udah pakai tenses tuh udah. Saya nggak mau lagi ngomong tenses karena semua orang langsung mental block. Aduh miss, block miss, ya. Yeah? I want to say it system. It's a system. System of language. Okay. Practice makes perfect. Ya. Yeah? Practice. Exercises and practice. This is the only thing that you can do. It's up to you. You're diligently enough to do this. Of course, you can improve your English. Okay. Conclusion. How important English is in your life? Nah, ini dia pertanyaan sekarang. Penting nggak ya English di saya? It's depend on you. If you feel that it's important, of course, you want to pursue it. And then, it's important. How will I improve my English? I give you several way to improve your English. Yeah. Okay. Of course, if you can attend English club. Yeah, you can join English club. is better, or you can say to your friend, hey, how about if this we meet and we always we talk in English? Gak apa-apa, ngomong aja walaupun dua-duanya nggak bisa, ya. Yeah? Tapi you practice your fluency and don't forget to read and write. Okay, and nih ada satu lagi, ini dari IF ya, saya baca. Kenapa alasan wajib mahir berbahasa Inggris untuk para pegawai, ya, para pekerja, ya. Kemampuan bahasa Inggris yang kamu miliki akan membantumu lebih mudah dalam mencari pekerjaan. Percaya atau tidak, saat ini hampir semua lowongan pekerjaan akan memintamu untuk setidaknya memiliki kemampuan bahasa Inggris dasar. Oleh karena itu, memiliki kemampuan bahasa Inggris yang lebih mumpuni akan membuatmu lebih menarik dibandingkan kandidat lainnya. Jangan ragu untuk mengambil tes bahasa Inggris ini. Dia promosi ya, serta kurikulum VD agar orang yang merekrutmu tahu bahwa bahasa Inggris yang kamu miliki sudah teruji. Ini karena dia. Tapi yang saya ambil dari mereka, bahasa fasih berbahasa Inggris di tempat kerja menjadikan Anda kelihat menjadi seorang yang lebih profesional. Okay, this is what I want to share with you. I'm your friend forever. I'm only an email and a WhatsApp away now. Maybe we can have our next question and answers.
Yes. Thank you, Miss Becky, for your second presentation. Wow, it's really good to know how to improve your English, guys. Jadi aku tadi juga belajar juga jadinya ya. Kalau misalnya pengen lancar banget ngomong, dia harus listening juga. Yeah. Kalau pengen lancar juga menulis, teman-teman harus reading, membaca gitu, ke reading gitu ya. Jadi tetap itu hal-hal udah ada pakem-pakemnya. Bahkan di awal tadi udah di-mention juga. Kalau kebiasaan biar bisa ngomong lancar seperti apa, you must say it gitu. Kalau nggak say it ya, otaknya gak terbiasa gitu, betul. Jadi tadi udah dijelasin semuanya sama Miss Becky, semoga teman-teman juga jadinya paham ya gimana caranya. Karena pertanyaan-pertanyaan di Q&A kolom ini rata-rata itu pertanyaan-pertanyaannya umum. Jadi karena tadi gitu ya, we already know the importance of using English, how to use English at work, but maybe it's common question is what is the easiest way for us to learn English. Jadi udah jelas banget, kalau pengen lancar ngomong, listening. Kalau lancar menulis adalah dengan membaca. That's it gitu. Jadi pertanyaan-pertanyaan yang berhubungan dengan tips caranya seperti apa, harusnya nggak perlu tanyain lagi teman-teman, karena sudah terjawab di dalam materinya. Tapi ada pertanyaan-pertanyaan juga yang menarik perhatian aku nih, Miss Becky ya. Jadi ada yang berhubungan dengan dunia kerja. Tadi aku baca itu yang berhubungan dengan pekerjaan sebentar. Oke, ini ada dari tidak ada namanya gitu, tapi dia tanya adalah, "Hey, Miss Becky, it's pleasure to hear this presentation. May I ask you a tip for from you about speaking?" Jadi dia biasa ngomong menggunakan aksen nih, Miss Becky. Jadi dia merasa nggak profesional gitu kalau misalnya ada ketahuan aksennya gitu. Dia kayak terbiasa mengadaptasi dari Singlish juga Malaysia. Gimana caranya untuk ngilangin aksen nih? Karena ini mungkin lebih naik lagi, nggak cuma lancar dan juga akurasi ya tadi Miss Becky ya, tapi lebih kepada ngilangin aksennya supaya kelihatan profesional. Itu gimana sih Miss Becky?
Siapa bilang tidak ada aksen mengurangi profesional? Nah, orang Kuala Lumpur gimana? Orang Indian, India pernah nggak? Have you ever heard about Indian talking in English? You know lah, Indian talking in English, right? Uh-huh, it's like that. You can use it. That. Yeah. Yes. Nggak apa-apa tuh. We don't see perceive him as a lower person. Yeah. Uh-huh. And then my boss is like, yeah. I give you examples. He's the number one boss. He's kalau ngomong ya, why don't you, why? Because he's German, yeah, so German. Okay, can you guide to me, why? Accent is okay, tapi jangan sampai, sometimes, kalau misalnya kayak, you have to, itu semua, you have to practice yourself, ya, yeah? How to put it down. Ya, karena sebetulnya bisa. Seperti, for example, this is language ya. Ini language, mau Inggris, mau Indonesia. Lucu deh, kalau orang saya di tempat saya ada orang dari Surabaya ya, ngomong bahasa Indonesia juga, karena dia kepingin banget jadi orang Jakarta. Jadi kalau ngomong lugu kayak kita orang Jakarta ya, dia malu sekali dengan medoknya kalau ngomong bahasa Jawa ya. Tapi waktu dia ke Surabaya, ketemu orang Surabaya, tiba-tiba ngomongnya kok tiba-tiba jadi punya pedok-pedoknya lagi gitu, kan lucu ya. Nah, itu semua tentang persepsi jadinya, right? Cuman okay, you have the perception, bagus kalau Anda mau improve or you want to change your accent, right? Jadi, tapi seperti apa? Change your accent, it means you have to practice this. If you want to become a British, saya suka ketawain ya, banyak guru-guru ya. Saya, karena saya praktisi ya, saya bukannya guru sebetulnya, saya praktisi. Kalau di guru itu seperti, kan masih ada pikirannya harus menjadi native. Jadi kalau kita lagi makan, so, do you know, saya pengen ketawa sebenarnya, karena sebetulnya gak perlu ya ngomong kayak gitu gitu ya. So, tapi she or he can do it because she thinks that it is very good. Itu menambah itu yang dia percaya bahwa itu adalah yang baik. Kalau Anda sekarang, kalau bilang aksen apa? Misalnya Anda orang Jawa, saya percaya mendoknya bisa kok. Yang sangat sulit adalah orang Sunda. Dari Sunda itu sulit sekali untuk menghilangkan ininya. Padahal kalau kita dengerin orang Sunda itu sangat sangat apa indah,
alam ya kan? Gitu, betul.
Itu di itu kan, itu orang Sunda itu sangat indah gitu. Tapi jangan salah, orang bule itu senang loh dengernya. So it is okay, it's okay, unless itu nggak mengganggu. Tapi mengganggu dikit ya, seperti orang Filipin. Have you ever heard Filipinos talk in English? Ya, solo cannot lah, lalalalahnya semuanya. Ya, jadi accent it's okay. Now we are in the era of global English. Englishes namanya world Englishes. Jadi bukannya native speaker. Jadi nggak ke native lagi. Sebab kalau ngomong native yang mana? Singapore English is native. Anda bilang itu salah. Ya ini nggak udah jadi native. Ya, nanti Anda ke Australia, Australian English is very different. Jangankan gitu. Sekarang Anda, kita kalau di London ya, kita masuk aja deh di Lancaster namanya ya. Nggak ngerti dia ngomong apa. Because it's different, ya. This void here, it is oid, semuanya oid gitu. Ya. So, first, what is your understanding about accent? What accent? Your Indonesian accent? I think Jokowi speak in Javanese accent.
Yes, definitely.
And it's acceptable. Now it is a world Englishes. Tidak bermuara kepada native speaker yang semua itu bermuaranya British atau American English.
Yes.
Berantem tuh berdua, American sama British. Yang mana yang mau dipakai menjadi world Englishes? But now we are in the era of world Englishes. So be yourself.
Yes. Jangan karena asumsi seperti Jakarta sentris kali ya, Miss Becky ya. Jadi karena
iya,
nanti terlihat logonya medok, jadinya nggak dikira orang Jawa, dikira orang mana, nggak enak gitu. Jangan kebawa masalah aksen, tapi nikmati aksennya. Tapi yang penting adalah gimana mengkomunikasikan bahasa Inggris.
Komunikasi.
Benar. Ya. Yes. Ya. Supaya orangnya paham apa yang
kita sampaikan. Iya. Itu yang ujungnya.
Good. Yes, thank you banget, Miss Becky. Kita akan lagi, kita akan buka untuk mikrofon dari teman-teman. Ada Sarah Avina sudah siap dalam pertanyaannya ya. Aku coba buka untuk mikrofonnya, boleh dong untuk ngobrol. Yuk, Sarah.
Ya, Sarah.
Sarah, are you there? Can you please open your mic?
Can you unmute yourself?
Yes. Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. I remove you from the top. Okay, now Salma. I'll let you to ask directly to Miss Becky. Salma? Okay. Can you listen to me, Salma? Hey. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We don't have any time, so move to Mega. Mega, can you please unmute your microphone?
Alright, Kak. Hello, good evening, Miss Becky.
Good evening.
My name is Mega.
Yes, Mega.
I'm a recent graduate. So I want to ask a question and also tips from you about to speak in foreign language, especially in English. So when I speak English, I often remember like one vocab in English, but in the other hand, I forget about this vocab in foreign language. For example, French. And vice versa. So sometimes I cannot just focus in English when I speak, and it just comes like a language switching, maybe in linguistics we call it a language switching. So do you have any tips for me to just focus in one language so that I don't think about the other? Thank you.
Mega, I want to ask you, do you do code switch?
French, yes, exactly.
You think in French?
Yes.
What is actually going on in your head? English or French?
When I speak English, I remember the vocab in French. When I speak French, sometimes I remember the vocab in English, but I forgot it in French, miss.
Okay. Actually, in our head, yeah, we have the boxes for vocabulary is actually separate. Why we know it is separate. Indonesian has another boxes. English has a boxes. Japanese, Kalimantan, it's different boxes. Remember, I have my husband's have grandma. This grandma suddenly stop talking in Bahasa Indonesia. Stop is like erased, karena because the boxes is already closed. Yeah, it's shrinking. That's and then he learn again Bahasa Indonesia using her Dutch. Yeah, through Dutch. So that's how we know that we learn from old people that we have separate boxes. So it's quite unusual for people. If it is Amiga, which is your language, French or English?
English.
English is your first language, and your mother tongue?
Japanese and Bahasa.
Okay, so that is your Japanese is first language, Indonesia is your second language, English is third language, and French is fourth language. Maybe, I'm just guessing, you are very fond of French. Is it correct? You love French language. Is it correct?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, you love, you adore, you embrace. If embracing, you embrace your French very much. But that's the reason you sort of like English is like lesser important than your French. You mix it because you want to remember about your French. It is actually affection. It is your affection that influences you. So what do you have to do? You have to put yourself to put the language for communication. It's not only you like it, yeah, but it is for your communication. I think the one that I learned, yeah, because that's actually my dissertation, my research now, yeah, like. The Indonesian that cannot speak Bahasa Indonesia anymore, now they speak, but they kind of hybrid, yeah. So they talk with code switching, but of course it is from mother tongue and the second language biasanya itu. So for you, if it is like English and French, you have a high affection. Your affectionate in French is very high. So maybe you have to have an affection also to English. So try to like the English. That's the reason I say I have the word I like English. See how powerful language is. Yeah, if you affectionate enough, then you are like influenced with that language. Gitu. Gimana Mega? Benar nggak?
Yes, yes. Thank you for the tips.
So, yeah, you have to have more affection to English.
Thanks. just like maybe I love Korean.
Yeah.
Yeah. So people can forget themselves in the yeah yeah affection, ketertarikan yang tinggi buat dia dari bahasa tadi supaya gak ketinggalan di bahasa Inggrisnya Mega.
And Pandu, do you take a course for your Korean?
Yes, but still the basic.
Later on, Korean. Right? Yeah.
Yeah.
the force or your effort to be able to work Korean is yeah. greater than the force you have to learn English, right?
Yes. Yeah. Kayak merasa kayak dengan film-film Korea atau lagu Korea lebih mudah mencerna. Tapi kalau dengan bahasa Inggris karena udah terlalu daily banget, mungkin jadi ketinggalan. Mungkin
bukan daily. We are introduced in a wrong way. Jadi bahasa Inggris itu yang diintroduce adalah semua bilang bikin bete katanya. Menurut saya sebenarnya Inggris mah bikin bete. Lihat muka saya. You know what happened? Ada murid yang pernah dia di UI di bahasa Cina, dia nggak pernah mau, semuanya dapat 4, 4, 4, 4. Dia nggak mau lihat saya. Dia bilang bahasa Inggris itu bikin bete. So, ya yeah, it is affectionate. Nggak bisa, itu proses ya. Semuanya kita cuma grammar, tenses ya kan, inget kan? Semuanya gitu. Nggak ngerti apa yang diomongin. We are not put into practice about the communication itself.
Yes. Wow, cool, of course. Thank you, Miss Becky. Mega, thank you pertanyaannya. Pertanyaan terakhir ini, teman-teman. Sorry banget yang lainnya belum bisa kerja. Karena kita udah malam banget, sudah tinggal 5 menit lagi. So, before I have some conclusion, maybe Miss Becky want to share something important for the last words.
Last word, okay.
Yeah.
It is about English as the power of English. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
The language has power. The language has power for your future career. Mm-hmm. So maybe you can think about that. That if you acquire that language, you more powerful in your hand. You have power. You have a more power in your hand. Itu aja.
For power in your hand. Yes, please remember guys, bahasa Inggris bisa jadi power. Nah, powernya banyak banget, kepercayaan dirimu, kepercayaan di karir dan lain sebagainya. So, thank you banget Miss Becky yang malam hari ini sudah menemani kita semuanya. But sebelum kita tutup, aku pengen ingatin teman-teman lagi bahwa tadi sudah disampaikan oleh Miss Becky juga ya. Kalau ingin lancar berbahasa Inggris, you must say it. Ingat yeah. Di grammarnya, vocabulary, terus expression, spelling, sentences, structure sama lainnya, panjangnya seberapa. Kemudian ingat juga bahwa ada 4 language skill, teman-teman harus kuasai. Tadi kalau misalnya pengen lancar untuk speaking, teman-teman harus listening. Kalau mau lancar di writing, teman-teman harus di reading juga. Dan jangan untuk tadi mau speak juga, latihan mimik juga. Referensi itu ternyata juga punya bahasa, karena dia adalah bahasa non-verbal. Jadi ketika kita nggak bisa bahasa Inggrisnya, lupa kosa katanya gitu ya, vocab-nya lupa. Baby apa ya gerakannya, saya baby gitu. Itu sangat membantu, jadi jangan lupakan mimicking juga. Kemudian yang terakhir, teman-teman juga bisa belajar bahasa Inggris di mana aja tentunya, menggunakan tools apapun, YouTube sudah ada dan semuanya sudah tersedia sekarang. Jadi please use your own creativity ya kan, untuk bisa boost your English. So alright, it's been 2 hours since we started the webinar. We have discussed a lot about the importance of English in our future career. We also did the Q&A session really well. I want to thank Miss Becky for making this webinar so insightful. I think the audience feel the same with me. And also, I would like to appreciate the participant who stayed from the beginning until now. You guys are the best. Congratulations. So I hope the next webinar will give us a very good impact for this future. So I am Pandu signing off. Thank you so much for your participation and good luck everybody. Thank you, Miss Becky. Thank you guys. Don't forget to screenshot this webinar and absen ya, jangan lupa teman-teman, nanti lapor ke fasenya masing-masing.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Thank you, Miss Becky.
Bye-bye.
Stopped.